live and alert on the north side of the dirt. It is your man D Real coming at you with another Be Real with D Real, where edutainment is what I do. Hello and welcome. I am here today to give y'all my review, might have a spoiler or two, on the Cloned Tyrone. Now, this just some people been up on it for a little while because they got to it before it dropped officially on Netflix just this past Friday. But I got a chance to check it out. And I am going to give you some of my thoughts. I'm going to tell you what I like, what I didn't like, and maybe a few things that y'all didn't consider because edutainment is what I do. Right. Okay, first, I'm going to let y'all peep out this trailer. Then I'm going to get on into it, give y'all context and whatnot, and let y'all know what I thought about it. Here we go. Check that out.
Crazy. Everything okay in there, baby? I'm just an average man with an average life.
Where the money at?
I'm an entrepreneur. I work in the spirit of the pimp game.
You know your girl gotta know what's going on in these streets.
No, get off me.
That's the car right there.
Bitch.
Slick, come on.
That make your spine senses tingle.
What kind of shit is this?
Like I'm in the twilight zone now.
Don't let the back door hit you.
We gotta go.
I don't know what that was, but that wasn't me.
Somebody is conducting experiments on us.
Great train. Come the fuck out.
This our homeland. We don't do nothing about it. Nobody will.
Chill. Just fucking chill.
Shit.
Oh, this shit.
Okay, we ain't got no time for no negativity. Go give me some goddamn wet nets. Something is pulling my.
Your pimp hand raised, and be willing to protect the ones you love by any means necessary.
I ain't scared. I'm a dope boy, remember?
Excuse me, kind sir, but if you could pour me to the elevator that leads down to the Fiki laboratory,
don't let the back door hit you.
I'll be out your atmosphere.
Let's get it, man.
We're on the scene trying to figure out what has happened.
I see this shit fall down. Out here cloning this. What the fuck going on in this bitch?
That's right. That is the prevailing theory.
Tell me, is it just a dream?
And that there essentially is what you're getting throughout the movie. To give you context of what's happening, what's going down in the movie, the main character portrayed by John Boyega by the name of Fontaine. He has this little pattern that he goes through, that he does, these things that he does every day. I believe it's like he'll get up, fix something for his mama. His mama will ask him, he'll ask his mom, do she want something to eat? She'll say something or other, and he'll move on. He'll go make his rounds, collect his money, you know, go to the little local liquor store or whatever, get him a pull tab, some blunt wraps, you know what I'm saying? The usual stuff. And every day, you know, he come out with a 40 ounce, you know, and then give the wino some, and then the wino would drop a little knowledge on him. Now, on this one particular day, he ran up on this cat that owed him money and was like, you know, tell your boss, you know, I'm out here, whatever, you know, don't be selling drugs on my block, this, that, and the other. Long story short, He ends up getting killed by these cats. Next day, he's alive. He's there again in his bed. And he goes through his same routine. He has no memory of what transpired the night before. And everybody around him is like, how you alive, Negro? You know, that whole thing. And so they end up, I think, either going to a church or a school or something, and then they find or abandoned project or something, and they find this secret complex where it's under the ground and they cloning mugs, not just Tyrone. And matter of fact, dude's name ain't Tyrone at all. Tyrone is more of a metaphor, if you will, because John Boyega's character's name is Fontaine, not Tyrone. So unless his name is Fontaine Tyrone or Tyrone Fontaine, and I didn't catch that. But either way, the bottom line is a bunch of folks. Jamie Foxx even goes in there and finds out, oh my goodness, I done been clowned too. You know, that kind of a thing. So they thinking, you know, how are we going to bring this place down? How are we going, you know? And basically, the movie has a finale. It's kind of a finale like what you would expect, but not what you would expect. Kiefer Sutherland turns in an amazing performance as the bad guy. Top notch. Loved it. Enjoyed it. Ain't seen Kiefer in a while, and when he did come out, he came out, he knocked it out the park. I enjoyed it. Also, John Boyega, Tiana Paris, and Jamie Foxx are excellent as the primary protagonists of this movie. The costumes, though this takes place, you know, in modern times, the cars people drive, you know, some of the gear is reminiscent of the 80s or the, and or the 70s, you know? And so it's kind of like, what era is this? That kind of confused me, you know? And I kind of ain't like that. But it wasn't enough to ruin the overall experience of the movie for me. I don't think I saw nobody drive a car that was newer than 1985. Facts. I'm just saying. But ultimately, we find out this little town they in isn't the only town where they cloning Tyrone. And so at the end of the movie, we find our three protagonists saying those very things. I don't think this is the only town this is going on in. And if it is, we got to go do something about it. And that is precisely the premise going down in this movie. So I think that's an excellent, you know, premise that if they could get those guys back and do a sequel with them out in some other city, you know, infiltrating the situation or handling it or making people aware of what's going on, this, that, and the third, you know, a la Zombieland / X-Files, you know what I mean? The truth is out there. We got to get it out there. We got to let everybody know, even if we got to shoot a few fools to do it. You know, that I see some potential, but I also see it as being a social commentary, because all of those tropes, all of those archetypes that are in those movies can be found in every single hood, ghetto, trap, whatever you want to call it, in the USA. Now, not so amazing is the fact that you can find tropes like this in any, you know, African-American neighborhood in the USA, but that these tropes exist in every ghetto, hood, trap in the USA. What are the circumstances that are creating these tropes, and why are they prevalent in just these neighborhoods? It's a poverty thing. It ain't a black or white thing, because they could be very well doing the same thing. You know, and it could have been called They clone Kyle. They clone Juan. They clone Chang. It ain't a race thing so much as it is a class thing. And when there's one class that's way above another class, somebody's going to take advantage of somebody in some way, shape, or form. And it often does. Overall, I found Tyrone, they cloned Tyrone to be a great movie. That's just me. I enjoyed it. Some people said they didn't like the tropes. Some people said they didn't like the conspiracy theory stuff. Some people said they thought it was too ghetto. You know what I mean? But if it is a realistic representation of said trope, that doesn't necessarily mean it needs to be seen, but the way it was depicted and the commentary behind it, I think was excellently done. Very well executed. The director, Joel Taylor, I think this is his directorial debut, but he's got like writing credits and screenplay credits on other movies, I think like Creed and some other stuff like that. Not bad for your first time out, young fella. Keep putting in that work. I enjoyed it. D-Real's rating, give it like a solid 7.5. You know, given some of the other things, you know, like costumes and era confusion, you know, that's what kind of, for me, it's just for me. Some people might give it a perfect 10. I don't know. But I enjoyed the movie. It was good stuff. Good stuff. I enjoyed it. I recommend it. I say you should watch it. Go ahead and watch They Clone Tyrone. This has been your movie review from your man, D-Rails and them. Holla at you, boy. Comment, like, subscribe, and share if you're feeling this piece. And I will be coming at you with another one of the mother ones. And until I do, yo, y'all be good. Be good to each other.